important part of the message.
Another rally to get the Purple Line's uncertain future on track. Officials from Montgomery and Prince George's counties say the business community is the push that's needed to convince Governor Hogan to keep the project going.
And this region productivity is tied specifically to the Purple Line. That's the message. And there could be no better entity to convey that message than our business community.
Officials met with local business leaders at the University of Maryland on Wednesday. Their message? Sell the governor on the need for the Purple Line.
We need to connect our major centers of commerce and our major centers of education to each other so that we can meet the needs of the future.
Governor Hogan has included initial funding for the project in his budget, but says a final decision will be made after the 90-day review.
If the Purple Line is canceled, the federal investment of $900 million, which will be green-lighted by the Federal Transit Administration, goes to another state. It doesn't come to Maryland.
The Purple Line would provide an east-west link between Montgomery and Prince George's counties, allowing for a more direct commute.
If the plan for the Purple Line goes through, the University of Maryland is one of the places that will see some of the biggest changes. This spot right here in the middle of campus could be home to one of the newest metro stops.
Without your efforts, your work, your advocacy, we have a real uphill challenge before us.
Its future may still hang in the balance, but county officials say the Purple Line has the potential to be the spine of the local economy. In College Park, Alexandra Cruz, CNS TV.